My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, divine light of the self. I welcome all the parents and children for today's session on story of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa's life. First, let us do namaskara, namaste. Namaste means the divine light in your heart, the Atma Jyoti. And divine light in my heart, Atma Jyoti, is one. We offer respect to each other. Let us offer our respect to Guru. Om Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लिसन द स्टोरी ऑफ श्री रामकृष्ण परमहंस. ग्रेटेस्ट सेज was born in 19th century. He was born in the year 1836. His father was Khudiram Chattopadhyaya and mother was Chandramani Devi. One day, Chandramani Devi, when she slept, she had a vision. A divine light filled the whole room. The divine light radiating filled the whole room, and Shiva appeared and blessed that a divine child will be born. After that, she becomes pregnant and gives birth to that. Whenever there is adharma in the world, whenever there is unrighteousness in the world, Bhagavan himself will be born in the human form to protect dharma. That is called avatara, the incarnation. Unlike a human being, the incarnation of Bhagavan is very different. Bhagavan takes the human form protect dharma. Dharma means righteousness. Uphold dharma and guide the society. In the 19th century, India was going through a lot of difficulties. India was in trouble. The Britishers ruled India for 300 years. They had spoiled the economy of India. There was poverty everywhere. They had taken a lot of money from India to Britain. Indian people had become poor. Indian people not only became poor, they lost confidence in God. They lost confidence in dharma. They lost confidence whether there's God or not. In that time, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was born. He is an Yugavavatara or incarnation, avatara of God. To uphold dharma, to bring confidence in the society, to rejuvenate dharma, to make people understand that God, there is God. You can see God, you can experience God. God is not an imagination. To bring that confidence, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was born. His childhood name is Gadadhara. He was called Gadadhara when he was born. He, as a child, he was very simple, very humble. And he always liked to chant God's name, think of God. He was sent to school, but his mind is always on God, always thinking of God. He comes home and he likes doing the statues of God. Using mud, he will create beautiful statues of God. The statues will be so lively. He will create the statue of Rama. He will create the statue of Shiva. He will create the statue of Vishnu. Everything looks so lively. He liked, as a child, playing with the mud, creating divine statues, God statues. That's what his pastime. He enjoyed chanting God's name, thinking of God, and creating the small statues of God. And he used to spend time in prayer, bhajan, and puja. One day, he was playing in the field. Evening time, a bird flew in the sky. Seeing the bird flying in the sky, seeing the natural beauty of the environment, the child Gadadhara started thinking of God. Oh God, you have created this such beautiful world, so wonderful. How much should be your beauty? So thinking of God, looking at the bird flying, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Gadadhara started thinking of God and he became unconscious. It's not unconsciousness. When the mind is completely concentrated on God, there is something called Samadhi. The mind gets absorbed in God. He lost his consciousness, of the outer world, but his consciousness, mind, merged with God's consciousness. That's called Samadhi as a child. As he grew up, he joined as a pujari, one who does puja in Kali temple in Dakshineshwar in Calcutta. While doing puja, he was so involved in puja. He loved to do puja. He enjoyed doing puja. He enjoyed putting flowers, dressing Mother Kali, doing aarti, offering naivedyam, singing bhajans of Kali. Kali, the Mother Kali, is dark colored. She looks terrible. The Kali, why she looks Why is she called dark? Because Kali means Kala. Kala means time. The time is not visible. Time cannot be seen. That's why Mother Kali is shown as dark colored, because you cannot see the time. You can experience time, but you cannot see time. She looks terrible because people are afraid of time. As the time passes, people grow, become old and die. The time is terrible for most of the people. But for Gadadhara, Mother Kali is the divine mother. She is the one who is protector. She is the one who takes care of the divine child, takes care of the child. Mother Kali is the universal mother. Actually, the time is terrible for people who are afraid of time, but who worship divine mother. Mother Kali is loving mother. She cares and takes care of the child, the devotee, very lovingly. She takes care of every need of the child, the devotee, with love and affection. She is not at all terrible for the child. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Gadadhara as he was called, worshipped mother, worshipped Kali as mother. He was doing aarti and he wanted to talk to mother. There is a stone statue of Mother Kali in Dakshineshwar temple. He wanted to see mother. He wanted to talk to mother. Is it possible for human beings to talk to God? Is it possible to human beings to see God? It is possible. With a pure mind, if you pray, God will appear in front of you. Ramakrishna Gadadhara had such a pure mind. His mind was so pure. With a pure mind, he prayed to Mother Kali. Oh Mother, Amma, show me your face. I want to talk to you. I want to touch you. I want to do namaskaram for you. Please come and show your face. Talk to me. I am your child. Because of your simple heart, because of his pure mind, Mother Kali appeared in front of him. He was able to see Kali just like he sees you and me. God is not an imagination. God was a reality for him. He prayed to Mother Kali. I chant and you can repeat after me. Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Jai Ma, Jai Jai Ma, Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Ma Ambe, Jai Jai Ma, Jai Jai Ma, Jai Jai Ma. So Mother Kali was very pleased. She was radiant, full of light. The whole temple was filled with the divine light of Mother Kali. Her face was glowing. She was wearing a green sari and she had her Trishulam, the weapon, in her hand. She was so pleased by the devotion of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa fell at the feet of the Mother Kali and did namaskara and chanted the praise of Mother Kali. I chant the sloka. You can repeat after me. Om Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadike Sharanye Trambake Gauri Narayani Namostute. Oh Mother, you are the most auspicious. You are the protector of all. And you are the one who gives the blessings, boons for all the desires of the devotee. One who is surrendered, you will take care of him. Oh Gauri, oh Narayani, protect me. I am your child. Mother Kali was so pleased by the devotion of Gadadhara. She hugged him. She took him in her lap and asked Gadadhara, "What do you want? I'll give you a boon." Gadadhara said, "Mother, I don't want anything. Whenever I call, you should come. Whenever I call, Mother, you should come. Whenever I give food to you, you should receive the food. And you should feed me the food." Now, Mother Kali had no choice at all. She said, "Okay, whenever you come, I'll come." Such was the simple heart, pure devotion of Gadadhara. And he used to call Mother Kali, and he used to cry in the name of Mother Kali. And the moment he cries, Mother Kali will appear in front of you. And when he used to do aarti for the mother, he used to sing the bhajans. And he used to dance. He used to dance because he is able to see Mother Kali in front of him. His name spread. People heard that the pujari in Kali temple is able to see the Divine Mother. People used to come to the temple to see bhajans and dance of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Gadadhara. He got married at a young age. And he married to a lady called Sharada Devi. Sharada Devi was also the incarnation, avatara of the Divine Mother. And when Sharada Devi came to Sri Ram, Gadadhara's house, Gadadhara saw the Divine Mother coming to his house in the form of his wife. He did namaskara to her. He fell at the feet of the Divine Mother, Sharada Devi, and he worshipped her. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was so simple, so pure, that he saw the Divine Mother in all women. He was able to see God everywhere because his mind was so pure. Sharada Devi is the Divine Mother and Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is the incarnation avatar of Sri Krishna and Sri Rama. That's why he is called Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna used to sing bhajans of God, all beautiful bhajans. Singing of bhajans of God, he used to forget the world. And whenever he sings the bhajans of gods, the gods used to come in front of him, appear in front of him. He worshipped God in various forms. The God can be worshipped in two forms, two ways. One is with the form, with a human form. It's called Saguna Upasana. God with form and God formless. Sri Ramakrishna did meditation in various ways. He wanted to Sama. He wanted to experience Rama. Then he said, okay, to get the divine vision of Rama, I should be like Hanuman. I should have devotion like Hanuman. Hanuman is the devotee of Rama. I should be like Hanuman. I should worship Rama like Hanuman. Then Rama will come. Then he thought that he prayed to Hanuman. Oh Hanuman, please come and show me how to worship Rama. So Hanuman guided Sri Ramakrishna Gadadhara to worship Rama. Gadadhara started thinking that Hanuman is sitting inside him and guiding him to realize Rama. So he started chanting name of Rama. He sat on a tree thinking that he is Hanuman Siddhi with him. And he started chanting name of Rama. I'll chant, you can repeat with me after me. Shri Rama. Jaya Rama. Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. Shri Ram. He started chanting Rama, Rama, Rama as if Hanuman is calling. Then Rama and Sita both appeared. They came to Gadadhara and blessed him. Then Gadadhara wanted to worship Sri Krishna. He wanted to have a darshan of Sri Krishna. What is the best way to have darshan of Sri Krishna? Pray to Radha. Think Radha is worshipping Krishna. There's no greater devotion than Radha. So Sri Ramak Gadadhara prayed to Radha. Mother Radha, show me how to pray to Krishna. Then Radha entered into mind of Gadadhara. So now Gadadhara started worshipping Sri Krishna as Radha. He started chanting name of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So as he started chanting name of Krishna, Krishna appeared in front of him. Beautiful form of Krishna, smiling with a flute in the hand, with a garland of flowers. Sri Krishna blessed Gadadhara and merged with Gadadhara, became one with Gadadhara. Then this is actually called the devotion. You can have devotion to God in various forms. When you have devotion, Gadadhara practiced devotion to Rama as Hanuman. What is Hanuman to Rama? Hanuman is the servant of Rama. So that is called Dasya Bhava Bhakti. Dasya means, oh God, I am servant of you. That's called devotion in the Dasya Bhava. And Radha to Krishna is called Prema Bhava. The love of Radha for Krishna. Then Gadadhara wanted to experience Vatsalya Bhava, or the love of mother to the child. So he prayed to Mother Yashoda, mother of Sri Krishna. Oh Mother Yashoda, you give me your love for Krishna. So I want to love Krishna just like Yashoda loves Krishna. Now Yashoda blessed Gadadhara. Immediately Gadadhara felt he is like Yashoda. He started praying to Krishna. He started calling Krishna just like a mother calls child. Krishna, 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 come. Just like Yashoda will call Krishna, the mother Yashoda will call her child, oh Krishna, come. So this is called Vatsalya Bhava, or love of mother to the child. This devotion is called Vatsalya Bhava. You can take any of the feeling, like a servant of God you can do, or you can do a Prema Bhava, love for God, or you can do Vatsalya Bhava. In Vatsalya Bhava, when Gadadhara called Krishna, Krishna appeared as a small child. Okay. He came there as a 6-year-old child. He started playing with Gadadhara. He played a lot of pranks with Gadadhara. He sat on his back. Okay. He made Gadadhara to carry him to all the places. So like that, he worshipped God in various devotion modes. Dasya Bhava as a servant. Prema Bhava as a lover. Vatsalya Bhava as a mother and child. Then a lady came. Her name is Bhairavi. She practiced Tantra. There are 64 different ways of meditation on God based on Tantra practice. Tantra is a technique. So Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa practiced these 64 ways of realizing God. These 64 ways are very difficult. Okay. Many times one spiritual practitioner practice it'll take 20 to 30 years before you can realize God. So Ramakrishna, the Gadadhara was so pure soul, for him just one day practice, immediately he realized God. In 64 days, he realized God in 64 different ways. So pure he was. Then he wanted to accept Jesus Christ. He saw the photo of Jesus Christ. Then tears started rolling from his eyes. The Christ appeared from the photo of Jesus Christ and entered into Gadadhara's heart. Gadadhara was filled with bliss. Then he wanted to experience God in the form of, realize God as Allah, just like Muslims do. He started praying to Allah. And he realized Allah also. So this way, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is only one saint who realized God in all the possible ways. Every single possible way. It's not at all easy. Even one way to realize God, it takes years and years and years of practice. But for Ramakrishna, for Gadadhara, you are such a pure, noble soul with such a simple mind. For every practice, it just takes few hours. One day he'll realize God in every practice. So he realized God in more than 100 different ways. And for all, realized God in all the religions, Christianity, Islam, Hinduism, okay, Rama, Krishna, then Kali. In all the form, he realized God. He talked to God, he lived with God. And when he does Naivedyam, when he does the puja at temple, when he does Naivedyam, Mother Kali will come and take the Naivedyam and eat. And she will take the Naivedyam and put it to his mouth, Gadadhara's mouth. And when he does, sings the bhajans of Kali, the stone statue of Mother Kali comes alive. And the stone statue used to breathe. So Gadadhara used to go and check the nose of the stone statue. Are you breathing or not? Mother, are you there or not? Mother says, yes, I am there. She's breathing. So powerful was his devotion. When you call with love and devotion, God comes. So this is what we learn from life of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. God is not God with love and devotion. God will come and stand in front of you. This is what Ramakrishna Paramahamsa taught. And he realized God in many, many ways, more than 100 ways, to tell and teach the world that God realization can be done in many ways. So people are fighting. My God is better. My way is better. My God is superior. Your God is inferior. My religion is better. Your religion is better. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Gadadhara, said God can be realized in many ways. It is not your way or my way which is important. It is your devotion, your love for God is important. In that way, he brought harmony in all religions. All of us are children of God. We should pray to God in whatever way we want. God will appear to us. But what is important is we should have a simple heart, a pure heart, and we should really cry for God. We should love God. This is what he taught. So then, one day, a master called Totapuri comes. He tells Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, so far you have worshipped God with form. Now it is time you merge with God. With God, when you worship with form, you can talk to God, you can interact with God. You can worship, you can pray to God, you can touch God, you can feel God, you can play with God. You are God with form. Now it's time you can merge with God. So that is called formless. God with form is called Saguna. God which is formless is called Nirguna. You can merge with God. It is like sugar. When you love God, when you see God in form, you enjoy God, you play with God. It's like eating sugar. It's so sweet, so enjoyable, so nice to be in the presence of God. But merging with God means instead of eating sugar, you become sugar. So Totapuri taught Ramakrishna Paramahamsa how to merge with God. Nirguna, Nirakara, Brahman. So he taught him the teaching of Vedanta, Tattvamasi. You are God. You are Brahman. Actually, all of us are God. All of us are Brahman. God is in our heart, but we don't know. So when we understand the teaching of Vedanta, understand the teaching of Rishis, Tattvamasi, you are that, and take our mind inwards, we merge with God. We become one with God. We dissolve in God. Then there's no more Gadadhara. Now what is there? Only God is there operating through that body. The God of the body of Gadadhara got transformed because now there's no more Gadadhara. Gadadhara has merged with God. He has become one with God. So the body of Gadadhara is operated by God himself now. So when you see him, the human body, there's no longer a Gadadhara is there. There's now God operating the body. And that's why that day onwards, Gadadhara became Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa means one who has merged with God. There's no longer individual. There's no longer Gadadhara. Gadadhara merged with God, and God only is there. And that's why he is called Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Because he realized Krishna, and he merged with completely with God. There's no longer individual left. So this is the story of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He inspired many, many people. One boy, nobody is able to say, I'm seeing God. He comes to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa and asks him. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa says, yes, I have seen God. I'll show you also. Come. And he touches the chest of Vivekananda. Immediately, Vivekananda experiences God. And he is so blissful, so joyful. He merged. He started crying. So beautiful experience of God. Then Vivekananda became a disciple of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. And he took the message of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa to all over the world. And he gave courage to Hindus, courage to Indians. Your dharma is correct. Okay, you can follow your dharma. Our dharma, Sanatan dharma, Hindu dharma is great. All of us can realize God, and God gives us the strength. Thus, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa brought strength and courage in Indians, where Indians had lost faith in dharma. He brought faith in dharma, faith in realizing God, faith in God, and gave strength to Indians. Now Indians started becoming stronger. They felt, yes, our God will come and protect us. And then they started freedom struggle. And the freedom struggle eventually gave freedom to Indians. Many people, in the freedom struggle, got influenced by Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda. Vivekananda took message of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa and taught people, God will come, fight for India, get freedom from Britishers. India is the greatest country on the world. India will become greatest country in the world. India will become Vishwa Guru, universal teacher. And God, Mother God, Mother will come and protect us. So this was the teaching of Vivekananda. This Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is called Yugavatara. He is the incarnation who came to protect Dharma, give strength to millions and millions of Indians, courage to Indians, and eventually help Indians to get freedom. So this was the greatness of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. So let us pray to Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa and close the session today. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is called incarnation, avatara, yuga avatara. I'll chant the prayer of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. You please repeat. Avatara, varishtaya, Ramakrishnaya, tenamaha, avatara, varishtaya, Ramakrishnaya, tenamaha, avatara, varishtaya, Ramakrishnaya, tenamaha. Let us all pray to Sri Ramakrishna, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Please give your devotion to us. Show us the path to God. Help us to realize God. With that, we'll conclude today's session. I'll ask questions and you can answer on WhatsApp. Let us chant. Let us close prayer. Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritamgamaya Om Shanti 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 Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. May all beings have happiness, health, peace and love. May all be questions.